गुड मॉर्निंग नाइन्थ क्लास, दिस इज़ योर वर्क बुक फॉर द सेशन ऑफ 2020-2021। इन द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ इंग्लिश यू विल परचेज टू वर्क बुक्स। दिस इज़ वर्क बुक एंड दिस इज़ द हेल्प बुक। द बुक नेम इज़ इंटरेक्टिव इंग्लिश वर्क बुक। इट इज़ हेल्प बुक। सो टुडे we read chapter first of your workbook. This is for your practice and write down all exercises in your notebooks also. So let's start. Ninth class, this is your first chapter, verb forms, unit first. In this chapter we will study about tense or time. Tense is the form taken by a verb to indicate the time of an action, an event or state of things. Corresponding to the three divisions of time, there are three tenses. The present tense refers to the present time. The past tense refers to the past time. The future tense refers to the future time. Each tense has four parts. All of you know about that. The first part is indefinite or simple. Second, continuous or progressive. Third, perfect. Fourth, perfect continuous. First, indefinite. It merely states the occurrence of an action or event. It does not state anything about the completeness of an action or an event. Continuous or progressive, it indicates that an action stated is in progress and still incomplete. Perfect, it indicates that the action is complete. Perfect continuous, it indicates that the action has been in progress. Time and tense are two separate things. Time means the actual time, while tense indicates the time of the action or state expressed by the verb. Example, my birthday falls tomorrow. The verb here is in present tense, but the action shown is of future time. So, this is the difference between time and tense. Tense and their uses. A summary. A present time where it used an example. The simple present. General, universal or habitual truth, custom, a daily routine. Example, water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. 100 degrees. Number two, habitual action. I rise daily at 5:30 a.m. A permanent fact or a situation, this road leads to Agra. Number four, to express a dramatic narrative, when the curtain rises, Ravana is seen on the throne. Number five, to show future reference, the Prime Minister is reaching here tomorrow. Present continuous, for action happening now, at the time of speaking. She is reading a book. Action in progress, not necessarily at the time of speaking. I am reading Hamlet by Shakespeare. Number three, for future time reference, we are going to Shimla next week. The present perfect. Recently completed action. I have completed my homework. Number two, to express past experience, indefinite time in the past. I have seen this picture several times. Number three, actions which occurred in the past and are still continuing. Example, Tony has written a good article on women today. Means Tony can write स्टिल द प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस एक्शन दैट बिगिन इन द पास्ट एंड द एंड आर स्टिल कंटिन्यूइंग शी हैज बीन वेटिंग फॉर हर सन फॉर 2 years. Number 5, action showing present result. Example, have you been reading still? Number 6, uninterrupted action in the past and not happening at the moment. His legs act because he has been walking for 3 hours. The simple past, actions that occurred in the past, immediate or distant. I went inside and talked to the landlady. Next, habitual actions done in the past. They worked very hard in the past. Next, unreal condition or conditional sentences. If I had a car, I would ride you in it. Second, conditional meaning. Suppose he has come here. Number 10, polite request or questions with models. As, could you guide me to the railway station? The past continuous. For actions in progress in the past, the children were playing football. Number 12, for temporary actions in the past, the rich man was distributing blankets among the poor. Next, for two parallel actions occurring simultaneously, my mother was cooking but my sister was reading. 14, for description in narratives or stories. Example, Lilliput was walking down the road and was carrying eatables in his packet. The past perfect, to express an action which occurred before a specified point of time in the past. Example, she had gone to bed before 10 p.m. To show earlier of the two actions in the past. When he had bought the ticket, he went inside. To express an unfulfilled wish in the past, I wish I had gone there. The past perfect continuous. Action going on for some time in the past. Example, the children had been playing for 2 hours when they were called in. Now, in this chapter, all of you understood properly about what is the sentence, what is the tense, present or past. Present and indefinite, past indefinite, present continuous, past continuous, present perfect, past perfect. Present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous. So, all of you will read or write it in your notebook as a homework, all the rules point by point with heading indication also and example. That's all.